It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you discover anything unexpected this week that needs to be explained? In your explorations of science in the Renaissance, you encountered many different, sometimes contradictory, explanations. Interpretations have varied immensely over time and continue to be disputed even today. Let's consider three different factors that shaped the practice of science in the 15th century. First, the universities were an important context for science from the Middle Ages through the 15th century. What examples would you choose to illustrate how universities shaped science at this time? Second, in addition to the universities, courts and court patronage profoundly shaped the practice of science in the Renaissance. What examples would you choose to illustrate how courts shaped science at this time? Finally, the 15th century saw the birth of printing. Imagine that you are having a conversation with a friend in a coffee shop. Your friend says, "The printing press caused more revolutionary cultural change in early modern Europe than we have yet seen around the world due to the personal computer and the internet." Well, what factors must your friend be taking into account to justify this rather provocative assertion? Do you agree? Would your assessment change if the effects of the printing press and the internet were only considered with special respect to science? These three factors, the universities, courts, and printing press, profoundly shaped the history of science in the 15th century. What is the most significant implication of what you have learned this week? What is your interpretation?